All right, so the Wood Miser LX-25 can cut up to 25 diameter. This log right here is almost 27. So how I'm doing it is turning it long ways so the wide spot is from the bottom to the top and not side to side, because we can only fit through this entrance right here. I can slide that out to adjust for the log, but you can't make that square hole bigger. So I'm gonna have to take the top off. Now, this side of the log is 4 inches taller than that side of the log. So I'm gonna start cutting it in the middle and come forward and take some of the wood off here. Once I get the bark removed and have a good square pattern here in the middle, that's where I'll start drawing a design out. I might go for some tabletops out of this. I don't know. This was a big tree that died, and it just died this year. So I got it just in time before any beetles really killed it or any rot happened. The other part of it is right there. The rest of it is in branches right there. And there's another log behind that one. That there's the stump. You can see the stump right there. And we are piling up on the wood for firewood. So we got tons of firewood. Got to get this shelter built before summer gets here and the rain keeps coming in, keeping the wood wet. So it does get a little warped and you have to continuously rotate it. So it's important to have that stuff under a building and not like I have it right there. So this is what I'm doing right here. Just keeping an update of what's going on at JCB Farm and Garden. We are a nonprofit. We basically run out of our house right here and a couple other locations of all our board members have homesteads, farms, ranches. And we just document our life on YouTube. We accept donations at jcbfarmandgarden.org, where you can make donations, see different types of videos and photos in our gallery, read a little bit about our organization. We help homesteads that are basically in need with raising animals and growing food, plants and stuff like that, and donating it to them after they've been hit with a hard time, disaster, or just getting started, multiple different reasons. But we help homesteads, farms, and ranches out. And that's why you hear so much noise in the background. All right, let me get cut into this and see what happens. And just a disclaimer for anybody else watching, we're not doing informational videos. This isn't a how-to. This is cutting wood to do homemade products. We don't sell the lumber at all. So I don't know anything about selling lumber for in doing this for market. So I can't answer any questions. You want that? Contact a real sawyer. I'm just a backyard junkie, man. All right. Bye. Okay. So I've gotten some pretty good cuts out of this log. It is still on there and there is a lot of it on there still. Pretty wide, pretty big. But I'm down to the last side to take the bark side off. And this is a really nice board right here, a 1 inch thick, and then allow a little room for shrinkage. It will shrink down to 1 inch. The next one underneath, it's a little thinner, 3/4 inch. This one is a 2 inch one that is tapered down to just bark. So maybe a small end table out of this piece just right here, because it's not that long until it gets to just bark. So we'll see what I do with that. Couple other pieces that we can make something out of, plaque, wall frames for plaques, mounts, whatever. A lot of people like to put like deer mounts or stuffed animal or something on there, or fish or whatever. So those could be that kind of plaque. This is really thin, 1/4 inch, so I don't know what I'm going to do with that. But I just wanted to show you the size of this. Very thick on this end still. We're going to be squaring it up now so that it is equally 1 foot by 1 foot wide. So it's going to be a 12 inch cant when it's done. A cant, for those who don't know, is the beam, the log, like this right here. So when you look at this right here, these cedar square beams like that, those are called cants. So yeah, so this is gonna be 12 inches. Those are 4 inch cedars. This is oak. And this was growing again in the backyard right there. It's the tree that was that I fell just the other day. There's the debris from it, and there's another log behind it, and that's the other part of the trunk. This was the bottom piece. That's the middle piece. The top piece is over there. That log right there, and that log is hickory, and my blade won't cut it. Hickory's too hard. So we're just going to use it for wood chips and barbecuing and smoking. So get back to work and cut this off. I just wanted to do an update of what I've done so far.